With this presentation, I'm going to prove what the image of the seal of God is. I'd like to begin by first showing you what it looks like. So here it is, this small image here. This is the image of the seal of God. From now on, I'm going to spend the rest of the presentation showing the workings out behind how I arrived at this conclusion, so that you can too. I'm going to state various definitions of words throughout, so a good way to start is by first defining what a definition is. Definition: a statement of the precise meaning of something. The condition of being definite, distinct, or clearly outlined. The state of determined limits. This definition can be illustrated as a straight and narrow white line to represent the definition of truth. A precise and correct statement or answer for something. This white line of truth is in contrast to the black backdrop, which represents the many incorrect answers or distortions of the truth. This is an example of two compatible answers that are both aligned with the truth. 1 plus 1 equals 2. That which is aligned above is equal to that which is aligned below. Both will forever be compatible with one another. They will never not be equals. Together, they both share the characteristics of truth. Truth, the quality or state of being true, meaning truth is simply that which is. It is that which is in accordance with fact and reality. Words that are synonymous with truth include fact, right, valid, certain, accurate, true, correct, genuine, authentic, honest, sincere, real, matter of fact, law, principle. The truth is objective, as opposed to subjective opinion or perspective. Truth does not waver or change its definition. It always remains the same. It is immutable. It is that which has existed in the past and that which exists in the present. The truth will continue to go on existing. Truth is not dependent on it being known for its existence. It is that which is, whether it is acknowledged or not, liked or not. The law of truth permeates throughout all of existence and is in effect at all times. The qualities of truth are the same as those for God, the name of whom is mentioned in the book of Exodus, chapter 3, verse 14. And God said unto Moses, I am that I am. And he said, Thus shalt thou say unto the children of Israel, I am hath sent me unto you. God declares himself as being I am that I am, meaning that he is like the truth. He is omnipresent, immutable, and remains the same. I am that I am, or simply, I am, is the same as that which is. The truth. Hence, God is aligned to truth. Their properties are indistinguishable from one another. They are both one and the same and remain one and the same. Both God the Father and Jesus Christ the Son address themselves as I am, being aligned to the truth. John chapter 14 verse 6. Jesus saith unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. The word way denotes a space for passing or going from one place to another, a manner of doing something, or a course or habit of life or conduct. Words synonymous with way include route, course of action, procedure, manner, method, plan. Truth, as defined earlier, means the quality or state of being true. The word life means the property or quality that distinguishes living organisms from dead organisms and inanimate matter. The existence of an individual human being or animal, a particular type or aspect of human existence. Words that are synonymous include state of being, way of life, or condition. The true way to life is also described as being that of the straight and narrow. A strait being a narrow passage of water running between two land masses that connects two larger bodies of water. Matthew chapter 7, verses 13 to 14. Enter ye in at the strait gate, for wide is the gate and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction, and many there be which go in thereat. Because strait is the gate, and narrow is the way, which leadeth unto life, and few there be that find it. Another instance where Jesus declares himself to be the way of life is in John chapter 10 verse 9. I am the door. By me, if any man enter in, he shall be saved, and shall go in and out and find pasture. Now to look at what the I in I am represents. I, as a pronoun, is used to refer to oneself in the first person. As a noun, it means the self, the ego, with ego being the Latin pronoun meaning I. The pronoun I and the word I are both related to one another, as implied by how they sound phonetically. The word I, when used as a noun, means one of a pair of facial organs used for seeing, the faculty of visual perception, or used to denote skill in perceiving, discriminating, or judging. As a verb, eye means looking closely at someone or something with interest. The right eye depicted here is representative of God the Father, the I Am, observing his creation from heaven. The centerpiece of God's creation is man, with man having been created in the image of God since the beginning of the creation. This is the reason why the image of an individual man is seen reflected in the eye of God. Genesis chapter 1 verse 26. And God said, "Let us make man in our image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth." Genesis chapter 2 verse 7. And the Lord God formed man of the dust of the ground, and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living soul. God is truth, and truth is synonymous with law or principle. Man is made in the image of God, formed from the matter of the earth, and made a living soul through God, the Spirit of life. Therefore, man is the matter of principle. Principle, a fundamental truth that serves as the foundation for a chain of reasoning, a rule that governs the moral behaviour of an individual. The word principle stems from the Latin noun principia, which means first, foremost, beginning, origin, basis, leading, of highest importance. The word matter as a noun means a physical substance that occupies space and possesses mass, or to denote a subject under consideration. As a verb, it means to be of importance, consequence, or significance. The word man means an individual adult male human, or man can be used to reference all individual humans as a whole, regardless of sex or age, mankind. God is the template for man, as man is made in God's image. Therefore, God ultimately defines the moral behavior of mankind. The latter definition of man, for mankind, consisting of male and female, is the context used in this next verse. Genesis chapter 1 verse 27. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him. Male and female created he them. Continuing with Genesis chapter 2 verse 18. And the Lord God said, "It is not good that man should be alone. I will make him an helpmeet for him." Verse 21. And the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon Adam, and he slept. And he took one of his ribs, and closed up the flesh instead thereof. Verse 22. And the rib, which the Lord God had taken from man, made he a woman, and brought her unto the man. Verse 23. And Adam said, "This is now bone of my bones, and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man." Verses 24 to 25. Therefore shall a man leave his father and his mother, and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh. And they were both naked, the man and his wife, and were not ashamed. Man and woman are made in the image of God, therefore they too are individual, meaning everyone is individual. You and I are individual. That which is defines. You and I, as seen here, is simply an abbreviation of the pronouns you and I. The pronoun I is simply an abbreviation for the word individual. You are addressing yourself as individual whenever you use the pronoun I. The qualities of being an individual is what's known as individuality. And the word individuality is a contraction of the words indivisible duality. The dual of duality means consisting of two parts, functions, or aspects, or as having a double nature. The indivisible duality of the individual is in regards to the dual masculine and feminine properties inherent in every individual for their existence. The joining together of one of each of the male and female sexual reproductive cells during fertilization is required for the creation of every new individual. Each cell from each parent will contain half of the parent's sex chromosome pair. These chromosomes contain the genes which act as the blueprints for your body. One sex chromosome is needed from both parents. The combination of the mother's X chromosomes with the father's X and Y chromosomes at the point of fertilization will determine if the new cell will grow into a boy or a girl. Each distinctive male or female, while belonging to their respective sex, will contain both the masculine and feminine properties inherited from their parents. These are intrinsic to every individual. The indivisible duality of masculine and feminine, necessary for life, is mentioned in the book of Mark, chapter 10, verses 6 to 9. But from the beginning of the creation, God made them male and female. For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother, and cleave to his wife, and they twain shall be one flesh. So then they are no more twain, but one flesh. What therefore God hath joined together, let not man put asunder. Ephesians chapter 5, verses 28 and 33. So ought men to love their wives as their own bodies. He that loveth his wife loveth himself. Nevertheless, let every one of you in particular so love his wife even as himself, and the wife see that she reverence her husband. If the pronoun I is used to refer to someone in the first person, then the pronoun you is used to refer to someone in the second person. You can be used to address one individual or more than one individual. It is both singular and plural. I for individual means a single distinct entity that cannot be divided. If I is for individual, then you is for unit. As you is both singular and plural, so too is the word unit. Unit, a single complete person that can also be an individual component to a larger whole. The qualities of being an individual is known as individuality. Individuality, the qualities of a person that distinguishes them from others of the same kind. The qualities of being a unit is known as unity. Unity, the state or quality of being one, whether single or forming a whole from individual parts. The pronouns you and I together can be abbreviated to simply you and I. The spelling of you and I, U-N-I, is the same as that of the Latin prefix uni. Uni stems from the Latin word unus, meaning one. Therefore, you and I means one, individual. Matthew chapter 18, verse 20. For where two or three are gathered together in my name, there am I in the midst of them. John chapter 10, verse 30. I and my Father are one. You and I are one. The word one as an objective means being a single unit or thing, or being the same in kind or quality. As a noun, it means a single person or thing, individual. Words synonymous with one include only, single, solitary, soul. If you and I are one, then you and I are the same. Hebrews chapter 13, verse 8. Jesus Christ, the same yesterday and today and forever. I am individual. You are individual. You and I are one of a kind. Therefore, you and I are unique. The qualities of uniqueness originate from God, the template for the individual. 2 Samuel chapter 7, verse 22. Wherefore thou art great, O Lord God, for there is none like thee, neither is there any God beside thee, according to all that we have heard with our ears. You and I are universal. The word universal means relating to or affecting all. Words synonymous with universal include ubiquitous, omnipresent, widespread, permeating. Every person is an individual, one of a kind, the same as everyone else. But every individual is uniquely distinct from every other individual, one of a kind, distinct from everyone else. These two aspects of individuality can be denoted as individual distinction and individual correlation. Distinction means a difference or contrast between similar things or people. Correlation means a mutual relationship or connection between similar things or people. Here are a few examples of how these two aspects work together. Man and woman are distinctive beings. A man is not a woman. A woman is not a man. However, the correlation between the two is that they are both considered being part of mankind. They are both individual. The creator is not the creation. The creation is not the creator. However, they are both individual in nature. God the Father is distinct from Jesus Christ the Son. And Jesus Christ the Son is distinct from God the Father. However, they are both the same in being individual. Jesus Christ represents the fullness of the individual in bodily form. He is the standard that all other individuals on earth are to live in accordance with, in order to be one with the Father in heaven. Jesus Christ is the individual spoken of in 1 Timothy chapter 2, verses 3 to 6. For this is good and acceptable in the sight of God our Saviour, who will have all men to be saved, and to come unto the knowledge of the truth. For there is one God, and one mediator between God and men, the man Christ Jesus, who gave himself a ransom for all, to be testified in due time. The word mediator means a person whose role is to gain agreement between people or groups. Words synonymous with mediator include arbiter, negotiator, conciliator, intermediary, moderator, intercessor, peacemaker. God is individual. Man is individual. Therefore, the individual is God and man. The individual is the mediator between God and man. Not only is Jesus Christ the individual who reconciles all individuals with God, but the word individual is the word by which it is done. The word is what unites all of man with God. John chapter 1, verse 1 to 2. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. John chapter 1, verse 14. And the Word was made flesh, and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. If I am can be used to address the mediator in the first person, then you are can be used to address the mediator in the second person. God is the reason behind the existence of man. Man, consisting of male and female, is dependent on the unity of masculine and feminine for the continuity of life. Therefore, both God and the masculine with the feminine are essential for life to exist. The word essential as a noun means a thing that is absolutely necessary. As an adjective, essential means fundamental or central to the nature of something or someone. Synonyms include inherent, intrinsic, fundamental, elemental, underlying. The significance behind the word essential is better understood by recognizing the root word essence and its definition. Essence means the most significant element, quality, or aspect of a thing or person. Synonyms include soul, spirit, life, heart, center, nature, substance, principle. With man and woman being made in the image of God, the essence of masculine and feminine must originate within God. Therefore, God can be represented as the essence of masculine and feminine. However, this is not to say that God the Father is both male and female, but rather, like man, the properties of masculine and feminine make up the definition of God. The intermediary term between God and man is the individual. The individual is essential for life to exist. If I am is the name of God in the first person, then you are is the name of God in the second person. Therefore, I am that I am is the same as you are that you are. If I am the way, the truth, and the life, then you are the way, the truth, and the life. Life begins and ends with you. Life begins individually, and life ends individually. Revelation chapter 22, verse 13. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. Revelation chapter 21, verse 6. And he said unto me, It is done. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. Psalm chapter 24, verse 1. The earth is the Lord's, and the fullness thereof, the world, and they that dwell therein. John chapter 1, verse 3-4. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. Indivisible duality is the way of life. This is why God emphasizes the importance of marriage and sexual exclusivity between husbands and wives. Those who do support and uphold this standard earn praise from God. Proverbs chapter 8, verse 35. For whoso findeth me findeth life, and shall obtain favour of the Lord. Proverbs chapter 18, verse 22. Whoso findeth a wife findeth a good thing, and obtaineth favour of the Lord. Proverbs chapter 31, verses 10-12. Who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far above rubies. The heart of her husband doth safely trust in her, so that he shall have no need of spoil. She will do him good and not evil all the days of her life. The word virtuous as an objective means having or showing high moral standards, moral excellence. Words synonymous with virtuous include good, righteous, blameless, upright, high-minded, principled, honourable, respectable, praiseworthy. The word virtuous can also mean chaste, as said particularly of a woman. Synonyms include virginal, abstinent, pure, innocent, modest. Virtue or moral excellence is the treasure of heaven, spoken of in Matthew chapter 6, verses 19-21. Lay not up for yourselves treasures upon earth, where moth and rust doth corrupt, and where thieves break through and steal. But lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust doth corrupt, and where thieves do not break through nor steal. For where your treasure is, there will your heart be also. Now to take a look at the hexagram, what it represents, and how it relates to individuality and the Bible. This six-pointed star is called the hexagram. It is formed from the combination of two equilateral triangles, one pointing upwards and one pointing downwards. The upwards pointing triangle represents the masculine, while the downwards facing triangle represents the feminine. When combined together, they both denote the unity of opposites, or individuality. The two attributes of masculine and feminine for individuality can also be represented by two other attributes of individuality. The principle of individual will is attributed to being a predominantly masculine trait, while the principle of individual care is attributed to being a predominantly feminine trait. Together, they represent the individual's will to care for the individual. You will care for you. Therefore, I will care for you. Within the center of the hexagram is the shape of a hexagon. When three equally spaced lines are drawn from three of the six edges to converge at the center of the hexagon, the appearance of a three-dimensional cube is formed, having equal length, breadth, and height. In the book of Revelation, chapter 21, verses 15-18, the city of heaven is described as being in the likeness of a golden cube, And he that talked with me had a golden reed to measure the city, and the gates thereof, and the wall thereof. And the city lieth foursquare, and the length is as large as the breadth. And he measured the city with the reed, 12,000 furlongs. The length, and the breadth, and the height of it are equal. And he measured the wall thereof, 144 cubits, according to the measure of a man, that is, of the angel. And the building of the wall of it was of jasper, and the city was pure gold, like unto clear glass. Revelation chapter 21, verse 2. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride, adorned for her husband. Psalm chapter 73, verse 25. Whom have I in heaven but thee? And there is none upon earth that I desire beside thee. Matthew chapter 5, verse 48. Be ye therefore perfect, even as your Father which is in heaven is perfect. Now that the new meaning and significance behind the word individual has been established, let's now look at how this helps to identify the seal of God. As mentioned earlier, the definition of the eye is one of a pair of facial organs used for seeing. The eye can be used to represent the individual, as well as the pronoun I. One of a pair is the same as one of a kind, just like the individuality of male and female. Because the individual consists of the properties of masculine and feminine, one I can be attributed to the masculine and the other I attributed to the feminine. Together, they represent the state of unity. Matthew chapter 6, verse 22. The light of the body is the eye. If therefore thine eye be single, thy whole body shall be full of light. Luke chapter 11, verses 34 and 36. The light of the body is the eye. Therefore, when thine eye is single, thy whole body also is full of light. But when thine eye is evil, thy body also is full of darkness. If thy whole body therefore be full of light, having no part dark, the whole shall be full of light, as when the bright shining of a candle doth give thee light. U is for unity, unity being the state or quality of being one, whether single or forming a whole from individual parts. The state or quality of being one is representative of the state of mind of the individual who lives in accordance to the will of God. Colossians chapter 2, verses 9 to 10. For in him dwelleth all the fullness of the Godhead bodily, and ye are complete in him, which is the head of all principality and power. Now I'm going to reference a list of various Bible verses to show that you, depicting the unity between masculine and feminine for God, represents God's new name and the seal of God. John chapter 3, verse 33. He that hath received his testimony hath set to his seal that God is true. Revelation chapter 7, verse 2 to 3. And I saw another angel ascending from the east, having the seal of the living God, and he cried with a loud voice to the four angels, to whom it was given to hurt the earth and the sea, saying, Hurt not the earth, neither the sea, nor the trees, till we have sealed the servants of our God in their foreheads. Revelation chapter 3, verse 12. Him that overcometh will I make a pillar in the temple of my God, and he shall go no more out, and I will write upon him the name of my God, and the name of the city of my God, which is New Jerusalem, which cometh down out of heaven from my God, and I will write upon him my new name. Revelation chapter 22, verses 3 to 5. And there shall be no more curse, but the throne of God and of the Lamb shall be in it, and his servants shall serve him. And they shall see his face, and his name shall be in their foreheads. And there shall be no night there, and they need no candle, neither light of the sun. For the Lord God giveth them light, and they shall reign for ever and ever. 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 19. Nevertheless, the foundation of God standeth sure, having this seal, the Lord knoweth them that are his. And let every one that nameth the name of Christ depart from iniquity. Colossians chapter 3, verses 9-13. Lie not one to another, seeing that ye have put off the old man with his deeds, and have put on the new man, which is renewed in knowledge, after the image of him that created him, where there is neither Greek nor Jew, circumcision nor uncircumcision, barbarian, Scythian, bond nor free, but Christ is all, and in all. Put on, therefore, as the elect of God, holy and beloved, bowels of mercies, kindness, humbleness of mind, meekness, long-suffering, forbearing one another, and forgiving one another. If any man have a quarrel against any, even as Christ forgave you, so also do ye. Ephesians chapter 4, verses 23-25. And be renewed in the spirit of your mind, and that ye put on the new man, which after God is created in righteousness and true holiness. Wherefore, putting away lying, speak every man truth with his neighbour, for we are members one of another. 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 8-9. Finally, be ye all of one mind, having compassion one of another. Love as brethren, be pitiful, be courteous, not rendering evil for evil, or railing for railing, but contrariwise blessing, knowing that ye are thereunto called, that ye should inherit a blessing. Romans chapter 12, verse 2. And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Thessalonians chapter 4, verses 3-5. For this is the will of God, even your sanctification, that ye should abstain from fornication, that every one of you should know how to possess his vessel in sanctification and honour, not in the lust of concupiscence, even as the Gentiles, which know not God. Hebrews chapter 13, verse 4. Marriage should be honoured by all, and the marriage bed kept undefiled, for God will judge the sexually immoral and adulterers. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verses 9-11. Know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God? Be not deceived, neither fornicators, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor effeminate, nor abusers of themselves with mankind, nor thieves, nor covetous, nor drunkards, nor revilers, nor extortioners shall inherit the kingdom of God. And such were some of you, but ye are washed, but ye are sanctified, but ye are justified in the name of the Lord Jesus, and by the Spirit of our God. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verses 18-20. Flee fornication. Every sin that a man doeth is without the body, but he that committeth fornication sinneth against his own body. What? Know ye not that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost which is in you, which ye have of God, and ye are not your own? For ye are bought with a price. Therefore glorify God in your body, and in your spirit, which are God's. Mark chapter 10, verses 6-7. But from the beginning of the creation, God made them male and female. For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother, and cleave to his wife. What's on the mind of the individual? The seal of God. So that was my take on what I think the seal of God is. Feel free to leave a comment to share your thoughts regarding the seal of God. I'll return with more content like this relating to individuality and God soon. In the meantime, take care, and thank you for watching.